Hello everyone and welcome over to the second race of the NR2003 PMU Cup Series Season 8 here at Talladega. And moving on from the Daytona 250, for those who remember the race, the last race was quite a, well, let's put it, a somewhat fun start of the season, where it all began with the race being a bit of a derby, kind of a derby, I'd say. It was, there were lots and lots of cautions, and we had an unexpected rookie winner, and that is the likes of Jimmy Irvin. Jimmy Irvin becomes the second Daytona 250 winner since Cesar Cohen Jr. to win on his debut, and I think for the whole of the series, I'd probably think, I don't know, unless you count series one, we probably don't count that out, but, so yeah, so first race winner on his debut, Jimmy Irvin. So now we shall move on to Talladega. So today will be quite a memorable day, because guess who is back? Ruben Gonzalez is back. He'll be driving in the number 26 car for Rising Sun Enterprises for part time at least, after being ruled out for much of the season last season, thanks to the injury back at last season's Daytona 250. So Ruben Gonzalez is back, so hopefully he'll be up to strength in this coming race. Let's see how well he can do from there. So let's move on to the qualifying session. So who will qualify on pole for today's race? Hope. I don't know. But everyone, take your picks. Who's going to start the race where? And it's going to be Cam Wright Jr. who will start on the pole. Jack Halleck, second place. Leland Hill, third. Riley Hill, fourth. Solomon Sheridan, fifth. Blake Parker, sixth. Jonah Burridge, seventh. Drew Walker, eighth. Jimmy Irvin, last race winner, ninth. And David Dixon, tenth. And let's see. And Ruben Gonzalez will start 19th. And defending champion, where is Owen Scott? Owen Scott will start 13th. Not bad. But his brother, David Scott, who took pole in the chase, took pole in the clash, the Daytona clash race, he will start low down the field again in qualifying. He will start 32nd place. And who else could I mention? Oh well. So let's get on from there. So right. Let's all take a moment of time to hear the words in motor racing. And all the cars are roaring the engines, ready to go. Cameron Jr. on pole here at Talladega. He is still hungry for a race win in the US. And Jack Halleck is also quite hungry to win another race at least. There is the two Hill brothers sharing the second row, Leland Hill and Riley Hill, respectively, third and fourth. And Solomon Sheridan in fifth, as that is the season six champion. And there is the 08 car, that is Blake Parker, alongside Sheridan. There is a Jonah Burridge. Jonah Burridge is on the... is on the fourth row. I mean, he will start from ninth alongside season two champion Drew Walker. And that is your top 10. Is it Drew Walker? Sorry. So is David Dixon. Let me take a look again. Sorry, David Dixon is supposed to start in 10th. Sorry. I think we've got a bit of a mix. Oh, Drew Walker. Oh, unless that's weird. Hold on a second. They're not lined up properly. That's weird. Halleck. Hold on. So Halleck second. There's Riley Hill. And there is Blake Parker. And there's Drew Walker. But Burridge. Burridge is supposed to be sharing. Oh, sorry. Burridge stuff. I thought stuff on ninth. Sorry, my bad. Sorry about this, guys. So. Anyway, so we'll continue from there. Yeah, Jonah Burry is 7th alongside Drew Walker on the 4th row. And then on the 5th row, Jimmy Irvin and David Dixon. Jimmy Irvin, the last race winner. Could he do it again? Two in a row, maybe? We had seen two in a rows in two plate tracks. That is the likes of Ray Ayanami, who did it back in season two, and the first two races of the season, of course. So, what will happen here at this particular race? As we have gone green now, the pace car's pulling, and away we go. And Camry Jr. is going to try and take the lead. He's trying to hold the lead off from Jack Halleck on the outside, and it looks like that. I think the Hill brothers are trying to assist his teammate for the time being, as they're now trying to get up into the lead. So three of the Lee Motorsports drivers are now once again near the front of the pack once again, as what we've seen last race in the Daytona 250. They've been somewhat dominating for much of the race until the race got stolen by a typical random driver, not a random driver but a rookie driver who barely made any starts before. Hardly made no starts before, so basically his rookie season, his first actual D1 race. I don't think he's made any D1 races before, so. But anyway, here comes the driver himself, Jimmy Irvin, trying to take third. And look at those cars going four wide. It's not looking good at the moment. Riley Hill going really wide, but is he gonna hold it? Oh, look at that. Four wide. This is getting tricky for racing now. And the two Lee Multiples cars are trying to go head-to-head with each other. Leland Hill is now going to take the lead off from Cam Wright Jr. And there is Jimmy Irvin over there. We're at lap three, so we are looking good. Oh my god, caution again! Oh, at lap three, oh my god, that is the big one. Big one! Another big one, so early in the race. Eddie Flores Jr. appears to have got involved. That, it looks like David Rans as well got involved. And who else also got in? Who's that red car? Jackie Daytona got involved as well. Flandre Wilson also got involved. Oh my goodness me. And some more shenanigans. Casey Benz. Google went out of control. Leland Hill Jr. also got involved. Tyler Lewell got involved as well. think somehow some cars are going out of control. Some shenanigans on the grass. Vander Howell and Tyree Lowell. Tyree Lowell also got wrecked again in the second race in succession. Bradley Ream. Some cars have got some damage. Drew Walker also got damage. Not good. Let's take a look at the replay again. So, something to span. I think that might be Tyree Lowell. Oh, Tyree Lowell caused it on Wilson. And then sending himself onto the wall, taking other cars with him. Jonah Burge also got involved. Whoa. And looks like Bradley Ream seems to be the main viewpoint in this collision. You can see him. You can hardly not miss him, really. We'll take a look in just a moment, as so Bradley Ream seems to be the center of attention. Jackie Daytona does a magic roundabout somehow. Who's in that pink car? In that purple car, I mean. That looks like Henry J. Brown. Did he smoked? It looks like he might have been smoking, I don't know. We'll look closely at Henry J. Brown and see. Yeah, it looks like he's gonna smoke because he literally just hit the car. I think that's what the reason why. Henry J. Brown also out of the race. Or unlikely to be winning, at least. But let's take a look further up at Tyree Lowell, who is probably the main cause of it. So let's see. So Tyree Lowell clipped onto Flandre Wilson, sending her out of control and taking both himself and several other cars. What was an awful wreck, like a big one. What a big one. Let's go on board some of the drivers. Let's go on board Tyree Lowell. We'll go also on board Bradley Ream. And then maybe a couple of others. So anyway, let's go on board Tyree Lowell. Let's go on board Flandre Wilson. We'll go on board Bradley Ream. And David Ryan's. Oh, looks like Dylan Hayden also got involved. What's going on with Dylan Hayden? Some car they've got. Oh, Dylan Hayden just almost just managed to save himself. I think he'll be alright. He's just a slight tap. Probably won't damage much, so. Anyway, so we're back. Who just smoked? Oh my god, Xander Howell doesn't look good. Ruben Gonzalez also retires, as well as Enis Kakia. Dylan Hayden also went out. That's not good as well. Talon Saplu is also out. Leland Hill Jr. also out. And what was? Honestly, it's just a huge wreck. Anyway, the lights are gonna go green. Leland Hill is currently on the lead right now, and I've managed to finally show you the race display. You can see just now on the top corner of the screen, as the lights are now green and the flag is green, and we're going racing once again. Hopefully this should be a significantly longer streak before we can probably have our next yellow flag. And some of the cars have managed to keep going. Nicholas Wright has a bit of damage, also sustaining that collision I didn't see. Olivia Reynolds as well has a bit of damage. Drew Walker is able to continue on from there. There is also Blake Parker, who also got involved as well. That's also really bad. And Lean Hill is still up front, trying to hold on Jimmy Irvin. This could actually be Lean Motorsports season, because I think they're finally trying to get their hopes up, and they're trying to get their team right. Here comes James Jameson. I don't know if he's a Leland Motorsports car, because I probably am going to get confused. I'll double check with the teams later on, just to clarify, because I might have got things wrong with teams. So anyway, Leland Hill is up front. There is Anita Baggers. Ooh, we got five Toyotas now near the front. Quite interesting to see. Leading the Motorsports up front still, though. Aditya Bagos in the Rising Sun Enterprises car, and he is now in second place. James Jameson in third place now. There is David Dixon, probably the hungriest driver in on the grid at the moment. Oh, yeah, that's Sabre Fox, sorry. Oh, we have a DNS. That is Marcus Sanchez. So Marcus Sanchez did not start. Didn't see that coming. But well, I'll make sure I'll put that on screen. So Marcus Sanchez did not start. Anyway, we are back. We'll take a look right now. Let's take a look right now what happened to Marcus Sanchez. So Marcus Sanchez did not start. Let's see what happened, what the problem was. I obviously didn't pay attention. So how it all started was, he blew up literally at the restart, and I failed to see it. I failed to have seen it. Marcus Sanchez literally blew up just as they're about to move. So Marcus Sanchez will not be able to start the race, sadly. I don't think it matters much. Anyway. So we're back again, and here comes Aditya Baggers. Aditya Baggers now up in the lead. He does take the lead. There's Jack Halleck behind Baggers. Can't pronounce it well this time somehow. So as Jack Halleck now is on the verge of overtaking Baggers for the lead. Leland Hill is now in a bit of more danger as well, having led for some time. Now he's going to lose a chance of at least trying to keep up with the leaders, because now he's on the very outside. David Dixon also on the very outside. He's gone really wide onto the wall. He's, oh my goodness me, three wide. He's not looking good. It's not looking good when it comes to racing four wide. Solomon Sheridan now up into the lead. But how long they're going to keep it? If more cars join in, it's going to pose an even more bigger threat. An infinite collision somehow. We hope that they're not going to do anything ridiculous. There is a thing that's Zach Campbell in the 84 car also pairing as well. Solomon Sheridan now holding on to the lead. There is Nick Tander as well also joining in the leading pack somehow. We're on lap 14 coming up to lap 15. Solomon Sheridan takes the lead once again. There is Owen Scott, last as in the defending champion in the number 12 car, and he is also climbing up. Let's see if he can climb up even further as well. Let's take a look at some onboard cameras. Owen Scott, certainly the one not to miss. We're still green, we're still looking good. The lights are still green, all shiny green. Owen Scott now in second place. Let's take a look at great onboard rear camera shots of Owen Scott himself. Look at how close racing is from the back. Who's the car at the back alone right now? I think that is David Scott, Owen Scott's brother or cousin. I don't know. I think brother, younger brother. And Owen Scott looks like he's going to take the lead from the 11 car. That is his former teammate, Solomon Sheridan. Owen Scott will take the lead on the inside. It could have been a photo finish. Could have been a photo finish, but Owen Scott literally just got the lead now. Cars again going four wide. There's Cam Wright Sr. Oh, and we have a slow car now, and that is Olivia Reynolds. So Olivia Reynolds needs to start watching out. Oh, and here comes David Dixon. Now looks as though we've got three strong drivers now up in front. For the lead, David Dixon will take that lead. Or is he going to take that lead? Will this not going to be a distraction? Because he's not going to try and get past Olivia Reynolds alongside other cars. Oh, David Dixon got the unlucky treatment. He's getting blocked by Reynolds just very briefly, but now I think he's got it cleared out of the way. But now That will still... The lead to Owen Scott. Solomon Schreier and Nick Tanner are taking off from the rest of the pack. Will the rest of the pack be able to catch up? Angelina Patrick is also there. Some cars are lurking out from the pack, and I've not really seen them before. At least during the race until now, so... So let's see. Ooh, and we have a problem this time with Drew Walker. Owen Scott will take the lead from Solomon Sheridan thanks to Drew Walker. Drew Walker has been a very, I don't know, this looks like this might damage the team moral because he's somehow been able to block Solomon Sheridan. And yeah, so Drew Walker somehow blocked Solomon Sheridan whilst I think he was leading. And then Owen Scott was able to pass him and take the lead. Let's take a look at it again. It looks like that is certainly not good for the team when it comes to teamwork. Look at that. Look at that. I think... Oh, I mean, Solomon Schroeder was not leading, but thanks to Drew Walker, he had to slow down, and Owen Scott was able to get path on the other side to take the lead. I don't know if his car had any... controlling issues in as a result of the crash of the collision, but I think this will be driver to keep it. Oh my god, another collision, and someone just flipped over. What happened? Oh my goodness, Cameron Senior flipped over and Olivia Reynolds hit him. Oh my god, that is an awful slap in the face. And Sabre Fox also got involved as well. Sabre Fox also got involved. Who was that? Roberto Crown Jr. also got involved. At what? Lap 20. And this happened. Literally happened. So. Sabre. No, that's Aditya Bagas. Also got it as well. What happened down there? So. Oh my goodness me. So. Oh, Cameron Sr. suffered the most out of it. Oh. Oh, and Cameron Sr. just almost missed his father. Almost missed his father. We'll have to take a look at it again because that is just awful. Look at that. Another headline to see. I think Drew Walker was still blocking all the other drivers, and then. Oh, and David Dixon and Camry Jr. hit the wall, and Senior somehow sent himself. He got sent onto the wall and then flipping over like a. He just done a cartwheel here at Talladega, and taking hang on, and then taking Roberto Crown Jr. with him and Sabre Fox. They literally did not know when to slow down. I think I don't know what's going on. So let's take a look at it again from another angle. So Cam Wright Sr. Oh, Jimmy Irvin also got involved as well. And then Aditya Bagas also got hit. Wait, where am I? Okay, we'll look at Aditya Bagas. We'll take a look at him. On board Aditya Bagas. onboard cam Wright Sr. What was a summer thought at Talladega? Oh, wait, that looks like an injury for Camaro Sr. He literally got hit one more time. How many times did he got hit by the driver's side? Whoa. And I think maybe that could be an injury because he got hit on the driver's side two times and it was pretty hard to say. Hard to see that. Olivia Reynolds, three times they got hit on the driver's side. And it looks pretty hard. Oh, we need to save this replay at the end of the race. Because that looks pretty, pretty hard hit on Camry Sr. Let's take a look on board Olivia Reynolds and see how fast was she doing. How fast was she doing? She was doing 140 miles per hour before the moment of impact. Let's take a look at Roberto Crone Jr. Let's see how fast he was doing. He also didn't make it past Camry Sr. Nearly 160 miles per hour as well. Allegio also retired. Oh, Jimmy Irvin somehow missed him, so. Jimmy Irvin also out of the race, so Jimmy Irvin out, David Dixon out, Sabre Fox out, Ruben Gonzalez out. Well, that's pretty much it. What about West Cameron Sr.? I think he's likely going to retire, so. Wait, Cameron Sr. is still going? Oh, he's not going. He's not going to continue, so. And Cameron Sr. has confirmed retired. RIT Allegio will also retire from the race alongside Roberto Crone Jr., Sabre Fox, and Aditya Baggers. Olivia Reynolds also retires as well. So Irvin, Wright, Dixon, Allegio, Roberto Crone Jr., Sabre Fox, Aditya Baggers, and Olivia Reynolds all retire after the second caution. And away we go racing once again. Here at Talladega. So third start. Well, yeah, third start? Yeah, third start. Oh, and looks as though what's happened to Riley Hill? 17 cars left after around 25 laps. Oh boy. Well, I guess we're not going to see a lot of action, I guess. So Cameron Sr. Is able to continue. Although it will likely be slow because of that side damage. Let's take a look how bad the side damage is on the Cameron Jr. It does look pretty bad. I mean, it looks okay, but at least this would likely affect him for the rest of the race. I think he has a bit of internal damage. Anyway, we're back up front. Solomon Sheridan now continues to lead. As Jack Halleck is right behind in the 11 car, there's Nick Tander as well. And Owen Scott as well, also still strong. Still running pretty strong. And Liam Hill is trying to get back up towards the front as well. Here comes Jack Halleck on the 11 car. Jack Halleck, could he win his second race on the same track at Talladega? Don't rule Jack Halleck just yet. He's definitely getting better and better. Of course, he's got actual CT Motorsports equipment, and he's driving against one of the best drivers, or at least some of the best drivers on the field and in the series itself. There is Solomon Sheridan, his teammate, and there is Owen Scott, a former driver at CT Motorsports. And they're doing pretty well. Leland Hill as well, don't count him out. We've seen him dominating with his team back at the Daytona 250. So, could we see a Leland Motorsports car win a race this time, maybe? Angelina Pacho, actually, we've not spoken much about her due to the fact she had a bit of bad luck last race because of, you know, she got involved in the collision and we didn't speak much about it. So Angelina Patrick, so far she's actually doing really well getting used to the car. This is the 36 car. In fact, this is the hottest seat or the hottest car in the series itself, and on the grid as well. I mean, if you count the series itself as well. This car itself has won two championships, including last season and, of course, back in season four with Jerry Chen behind the wheel. But the 36 car is currently the hottest car on the field and the most successful car in the series itself. And I think Angelina Patrick is just trying to prove that she's well-deserving of driving the car itself. I think she's doing okay. You can see her now. She could end up winning a race if she can get up front of the leaders. There is Owen Scott, the driver that she replaced with. Owen Scott now driving for All American Racing, and will be driving the number 12. This is the first time we've seen Owen Scott in the number 12 since back in around season 2. That was when he was an independent driver before he got signed up to JCM, Jerry Chen Motorsports, the following season. Here comes Leland Hill on the inside now for the lead. Look at the 53 car as well. Davis Scott, another Scott brother, also climbing up as well towards the front. Eighteen laps to go. Oh, and Leland Hill now on the middle. I think Owen Scott is trying to do an unusual thing. They're trying to overtake Leland Hill on the outside. I think Leland Hill is trying to use the inside line to his advantage and try and maintain that lead, trying to at least get back on the 12 car. I think looks like both drivers have got drafting behind them. Owen Scott and Leland Hill have got Jack Halleck and Angelina Patrick behind them respectively. Not anymore, sort of. Nah, forget it. Forget what I just said a few seconds ago. So, I think Jack Halleck and Angelina Patrick giving Leland Hill some draft and Owen Scott some draft as well. But Jack Halleck getting the better out of it as he tries to push Jack Halleck into the lead. It does look like it's going to be an interesting rivalry between some of the best drivers. Leland Hill as well got involved in a number of rivalries, including most famously Tari Lowell. And Leland Hill back into the lead. And he's got Angelina Patrick behind him. Let's take a look at another shot of the camera from another angle. It looks like he's going to be one of these drivers that will certainly come home with a win. Where is Camry Jr.? Camry Jr. is slow. And he's got Drew Walker up behind him. So these cars are currently slow. But they're not that far before. Well, I think they're still pretty far, probably around half a track away from the leaders. And here comes Leland Hill, still holding on to the lead. Angelina Patrick getting a bit unlucky there. She gets pushed onto the middle side. Oh, four wide here at Talladega. Not so high up the order. I think that guy 54 car was almost trying to cause a collision again. This could have been a shocker. It just happened so high up the field. A collision literally happened. Remember back at Indianapolis, a collision happened. In fact, all the leaders collided. And yeah, all the leaders pile up before they piled up and then they brought up the caution. All the leaders basically. So that's how it happened. So it's quite an unusual way to call the caution, if not crazy. And then here comes Leland Hill. He's still leading the race. Leland Hill is so far looking good at the moment. As we're coming up to 12 laps to go. Here comes Jameson on the 75 car, and he tries to take second place and will go after his friendly driver, Leland Hill, up in front. We're coming up to 10 laps to go. Another caution! Angelina Patrick, Jack Halleck, and that Campbell got involved. Oh my gosh. They were in the leading pack until they just basically collided with each other. Angelina Patrick got involved again in the second race in succession. What happened round there? I thought she was doing quite well, I don't know what happened. Oh, she clipped onto Jack Halleck and then Zach Campbell, sending them both onto the wall in what was a surprising incident. We gotta take a look at that. That is just surprising. So high up the order. Don't know if any of them are gonna continue. But oh boy. So let's go on board Angelina Patrick. It's a bit of bad luck for the driver herself. Yeah, I don't think she'll be able to continue. Jack Halleck as well, probably not going to be able to continue. Jack Halleck. This could have been a chance for him to win another race, this time at the same track that he won his only race at, and it just ended so suddenly. Zach Campbell also got involved. What a wreck. And Nick Tanner takes the lead. And away we go. We've got like 7 laps to go. Here we go. We go racing again. So who is going to win after the next 7 laps? Coming up to 6 laps now. As Nick Tander, let's see how long he can hold the lead up. How long he can hold the leader. There's number 53 car, David Scott. There's James Jameson as well, and Solomon Schoen as well. All queuing behind Nick Tander. As we've not got long to go here. And Dex Mizaki as well also joins in. There is Ray Anami and Jace Javelli, to name a few. Riley Hall also keeping in bay of the leading pack right now. Still, keeping himself at bay. There is also Patrick Thompson. I think he's got damage. I don't know if he'll be able to continue. And hold on. Yeah, Patrick Thompson. And blah, 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 blah. Anyway, back towards the front. And it looks like that Davis Scott will try and take the lead. Or will it be? Or looks like James Jameson now also. Also looks like they're going 3 wide. Making it 3 wide here. Oh, not quite 3 wide. Leland Hill is trying to get back at Nick Tander for the lead. And it's certainly getting a bit hard poundish right now, because we know it is always going to happen during the last few laps of the race. As Leland Hill is trying to do his best to try and overtake the 75 car of Nick Tander. There is Owen Scott. Don't rule him out just yet. Also don't rule out Solomon Sheridan too. Maybe David Scott as well can also prove himself the best out of anyone else, probably the next Owen Scott after his brother. So still don't rule him out just yet, as Nick Tanner is still up in front of up in front and in the lead, still in the lead. Somehow he's got some interesting defensive driving. We're now coming up to 3 laps to go. And, well, what will the others do? What will Leland Hill do? Leland Hill is still up in second place. Well, he was down in third. Now trying to do something with the 75 car. Oh, they've both got drafting. Leland Hill's now being pushed by the 11 car now. There's Jace Tavelier as well. Also in the drafting line as well. Ooh, and Leland Hill now up in front now this time. And was able to just barely push away from Nick Tanner. Was able to push Nick Tanner out of the way after all this somewhat defensive driving. There is Solomon Sheridan. Solomon Sheridan now battling alongside the 54 car. And we're now on the penumbra lap of the race. Oh, and now going 3 wide for the lead. Who's going to be up front? There is the 54 car. And I think Nick Tanner is going to try and give him a bit of drive. All 3 wide. James Jameson as well, doing the push as well on the 12 car. Owen Scott. Owen Scott now in the lead as we're coming up to the white flag of the race. They're still on triple file. Oh my goodness me, is getting closer and closer when it comes to racing. Who is going to win here at Talladega? Will it be Sheridan? Will it be Leland Hill? Or will it be Owen Scott? Leland Hill has led the last lap, but who will come up front? Oh my goodness me, I am literally heart pounding right now. It is going to get closer and closer. Who will be up front? Solomon Sheridan currently up front right now, but it is only one corner to go. Will it be? Here comes Owen Scott. Oh, not quite. I think Solomon Sheridan is just... Oh my goodness me. Whoa! At the last lap, Owen Scott lost it. I don't know what car he hit. I got to replay that. But Solomon Sheridan has taken the victory here at Talladega. Oh my goodness me. That last lap was a huge... Well, it was quite a scare. Owen Scott just lost it. Just before they're about to hit the finish line, who did he hit? He hit Leland Hill. He was in third place. Now he's fallen down to, barely, literally at the back of the pack. Oh my days. Owen Scott lost it, but Solomon Sheridan has taken the win. Oh my days. Owen Scott slips down to 9th. Lynn had a bit of side damage. Oh my goodness me, they're going to have a huge fight when the race ends. That was a bit of a scare, honestly. Where is Owen Scott now? He's right there. We got to go on board, because that was a great way to end the race. Probably not the best, but you can see how scary Owen Scott was. Yeah, Owen Scott was trying to hold his position before the end of the race, and somehow he's lasted thanks to that just one slight touch on Leland Hill, causing a bit of side damage on Leland Hill. There he is, now onto the grass. There it is from another angle. In fact, he was one of the three drivers battling in the lead on the last lap, and somehow he just lost it. He took out Leland Hill. In fact, those two drivers that go hit, they touch each other. That and their chance of winning, and that will give the win to Solomon Sheridan. But oh boy, what a race we've seen. What a race we've seen. Anyway, so Solomon Sheridan wins. Leland Hill in second place. James Timmons in third. Jace Tavelia fourth. David Scott fifth. Nick Tandra sixth. Ray Anami seventh. Dex Mizaki eighth. Owen Scott ninth. And Riley Hill tenth. And the rest, you know where you finish. Look at that. High attrition of races. Look at this high attrition of drivers retiring from the race. And yes, Marcus Sanchez has confirmed will be marked as a DNS, did not start in this race. Sorry, Marcus Sanchez, for not being able to pay attention to you earlier on. But it's a shame though, because this is a great race. Hell of a great race. I gotta play that either tomorrow or the next or the day after tomorrow. So anyway, fastest lap time is gonna go to Jace Tavelia, 46.706. And take a look at the results one more time. Okay, so there we go. So I'm so determined to show this race, because this is certainly a must watch. So right, so that's it. So that's all the two super speedway races to mark the opening races of the season. It's been obviously a fun start, a chaotic start, or how to put it, let's say a crushing start to begin with. It was there was lots of action going along, and so far how the mod is behaving, this somehow brings exciting races. So right, so let's wrap up the stream for now. So I will check and see what the third race will be, but whatever third race will be, I will hopefully see all of you guys at least. Maybe if not, then who knows, but I will hopefully see at least some of you guys at the next race, which will be the third race of the season. So take care, everyone. I will see you all there back on the track very, very, very soon.